Good morning, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It is my great honor and pleasure to introduce the eminent Professor Ikuo Tohata as a keynote speaker at this conference, where he will shortly present on the topic of soil improvement under existing tile for mitigation of future earthquake damage. Among his many distinguished affiliations, Professor Tohata is the current Vice President for Asia of the International Society for Soil Mechanics and Geotechnical Engineering. And he has just finished his term as the President of Japanese Geotechnical Society. Professor Tohata was born in Kobe and obtained his bachelor, master, and doctoral degree from the University of Tokyo. His academic experience began as a research associate and lecturer at the University of Tokyo, where he is now an emeritus professor. Further to this, he is also a visiting professor at the Kanto Kakuin University in Yokohama and a distinguished visiting professor at the Indian Institute of Technology in Mumbai. Professionally, Professor Tohata also find time to be the director of Tohata Architects and Engineer, which is the design firm set up by his grandfather about 80 years ago. He is also an advisor of the Chuo Kaihatsu Corporation in Japan. Professor Tohata has a very profound relationship with Thai engineers and Thailand. It began in 1985 when he was a young visiting professor at AIT and at Yulalongkorn University. During that time, he practiced speaking and writing Thai. He enjoyed Thai food very much, especially tom kha kai and Thai massage. And he can play takaw. Yeah. And actually, after returning back to Japan, his name plate in front of his office was written in Thai. So I'm surprised to saw his name in Thai in the University of Tokyo. Okay. And he also has been Thai student. Even after returning to the University of Tokyo, he accepted many Thai students, including me, as his advisee. So, and further to this, he sent his son to study here in Thailand at AIT. Okay. Needless to say, he liked Thailand very much. Okay. Professor Tohata has more than 400 English papers published in international journals and conferences, as well as a comprehensive book on geotechnical engineering published by the Springer in 2008. Professor Tohata has a wide varied research interest, which includes the dynamic analysis of earth structure during earthquakes and the permanent displacement of ground caused by seismic liquefaction, which leads us to today's presentation. We are greatly honored to have Professor Tohata as today. We are greatly honored to have Professor Tohata today as a keynote speaker at our conference. And may I invite everyone to join me in welcoming him back to Thailand and inviting him to the stage. Please, Professor Tohata.
Pom tamganti AIT sompina yukrunte di mark kai yu nai soi tonlo soi hashi pa sompi tegon tinan medai mi arai de diau ni mi tukyai makmak tinan tokujai mark ka So 30 ปีก่อนประเทศไทยเป็นประเทศกำลังพัฒนาแต่เดี๋ยวนี้ประเทศไทยเป็นกำลังพัฒนาเร็วแต่พัฒนาเร็วยังไม่พอจริงๆมีต้นคุณต้นทำอะไรอะไรทำกันมากมากมีทางด่วนมีรถไฟแต่คุณไม่จบน้ำท่วมคุณต้นทำงานมากนะสู้後輩チョークディーナカップここを含まるコートのマークティーポンプーパサーパサータイマイコイゲンじゃあトンプーパサーアングリーじゃあスライド I'm now working in India. This is a very very recent festivalIndia is still developing. They have many, many problems. And okay, next, please. I should do this. Okay. This is my topic. I'm going to talk about my recent experience. Then I have been the president of the Japanese Geotechnical Society. There are many problems to tackle. And one of them was the relationship with people. So I analyzed the geotechnical engineeringachievement so far. Okay, as you know very well, our discipline achieved many, many things. There are many nice things, knowledge of soil, ground, rock behavior, certainly, and you have many, many skills for field investigation, laboratory testing, construction. Okay, you can predict both, for both practice and research, and you have skills for safe construction,And now you have a nice system of rationalized technology, and you can satisfy your clients. That's very, very nice. However, Geotechnical Society Japan encountered many problems because of these things. Well, people, the public, does not recognize our discipline. They take everything for granted. They don't care our efforts. And second one, certainly you have nice technology for field investigations. However, you can use, or we can use that achievement for saving total construction cost. Public sector's clients do not yet understand our importance for money saving. And people always imagine that a good superstructure is good enough, but they don't know.The structures are not reliable if foundation is poor. This is what they don't understand. So direct collaboration with people. This has been my important theme as the president of the Japanese society. So let people recognize us. So today I'm going to show you my recent small effort.I try to show up in front of people as much as possible. And this is one of the topics, Urayasu City, which is located southeast of Tokyo. This city was totally destroyed by 2011 earthquake. Okay, you can notice that this city is made up of three parts. Red color means the original old land. This is a very safe area. But then construction of islands started after 1965.Yellow part was constructed first, and followed by white or gray or light blue part. And 2011, magnitude 9, terrible earthquake damaged this area. So this is one of the scenes in open area. So, but same things happened immediately under houses. So people were very, very much affected by this event. Lots of water came out, and bearing capacity was completely lost. So soil improvement was a very essential work for reconstruction of the city. And I spent lots of time on this project as the president of the society, and I was also chair.Of the technical advisory committee of this area. And okay, here I show the people's general acceptance. This was an important issue in this project because we have to touch soils under their houses. So I'm going to talk about damage, soil condition, types of restoration, underground grid wall, and construction plan, cost, etc., and local acceptance agreement. So number six is still ongoing, not finished. So anyhow, first stage is like this. Okay, this is a map around Tokyo. Scale is around 100 to 100 kilometers. And the red color indicates the sites of soil liquefaction and houses are damaged, lifelines are damaged, river levees are damaged. And since then, I didn't have much time to take a rest. And older soil, actually, did not liquefy. Old means, in my personal idea, older than 100 years old. So most damage happened in very young soil. Young means younger than 70 years. So if you are 70 years old, I call you young. I'm 61 now, so I'm very young. That's good news. Okay, so Urayasu City is here. Maybe you know Tokyo Disneyland. Disneyland is located in Urayasu City, and this city got lots of tax money from the Disneyland. So city has some good funding to help the people's house from liquefaction. So this is a distribution of liquefaction in this Urayasu City, and blue color is a safe area. This area is an old peninsula. Age is maybe 1,000 years or older, and nothing happened there. But in Young Island, had very bad problems. And Disneyland is somewhere here, and the bottom left. And Disneyland company had a nice idea of business continuations. So they did some soil improvement during construction. So business continued without much damage. But in residential area, was not prepared at all. So heavy damage happened, and the people are very much in tough conditions. So there are always careful people. They spend some money to improve their soil, but most people are not engineers. So they didn't know anything about soil improvement or bearing capacity, no ideas. So now people started complaining, so public sectors decided to help those people. So this is a typical damage. Structurally, no damage. But subsidence, sinking, tilting stopped the damage, stopped the operations. Also, because of this 10 centimeter, 20 centimeter sinking, lifeline connection stopped. Gas pipe supply stopped, water supply stopped. So this is a typical damage, but nobody was killed. That's a bit good news. And also here, okay, say 8,700 houses were affected by liquefactions. So they needed some help. Because so this is a situation immediately after the earthquake. And I would say if the tilting is greater than 6 over 1,000, that means 6 centimeter differential settlement over 10 meter distance is already fatal to the health of people. Health problem is headache and dizziness, so they cannot stay in house. And also this is a differential subsidence. So this building is supported by fire foundations. So no effect happened, but surrounding soils was consolidated after drainage of poor waters. So this is a classic consolidation problem. And one big problem was this happened to firefighters' stations. So immediately after the earthquake, emergency activity was totally stopped. Firefighters could not go out. And this also damaged the sewage lifelines. So manholes floated almost 2 meters, and toilet water could not be treated anymore. because of this destroyed lifeline problems. So you see here the two pipelines, two sections are separated, and lots of backfill sand came in and to stop the water flow. So cleaning took many, many days. So even now, most lifelines are just temporary lifelines. And complete restoration is going to start now. Already, you know, five years have passed, but still, restoration work is going on. So local community was seriously affected. Now, Urayasu city is very famous as a liquefaction city. So today, now you come to know that Urayasu is famous for liquefaction, and city mayor is worrying about the future of the city. So city decided to spend time and money for reconstruction of the soil conditions. And because of this situation, some people decided to move out of the city. This means a decrease in population and decrease in tax income to the cities. So city wants to stop this situation. But I believe that the city deserves to live because of very nice, comfortable planning and living conditions, something like this, nice flat houses surrounded by green field. I like that city. Also, commuting time to city center of Tokyo is 15 minutes. That's a very convenient place. So we should not give up this city. Engineers should help reconstruction of the city. That has been my policy as the president of the society. But difficulty was soil improvement under existing houses. You can easily understand this. I like such a thing in India. This is Buddhism. So soil conditions, okay. Urayasu city has a long history as a fisherman's or a commercial town since maybe 12th century. Soil condition is not too bad in the original part of the city. So this is a map in 1931. So this part is a peninsula. No problem, happened in 2011. Nothing happened here. However, land reclamation project started in 1960s without paying attention, much attention to liquefaction. Here, the major geotechnical problem was consolidation. And islands were constructed by dredging of seabed sand, and soil conditions quite different from place to place. That was also a big problem during my committee working. Distance from pumping, discharging station changed soil conditions very much. Okay, this is the idea of dredging. The soil is pumped up from seabed, mixed with water, transported to the site, and discharged like this. So soil is more sandy near the sand discharge and more silty at longer distance. This is just natural phenomenon. So location of sand discharge changed many times. So this changing made soil condition very, very complicated. And the consolidation settlement more than 100 centimeters occurred in 1970s and 80s. This record of subsidence, horizontal axis the year, 1970, 80, 90, vertical axis subsidence, that you can notice that maximum subsidence was 140 centimeters at some places. And people still remember that bad phenomenon. They had big problems in those days. This is important. And okay, geologists classify this area into many, many groups of geomorphology, natural levy, backmarsh, former water area, and et cetera, et cetera. So actually, my research committee, advisory committee, conducted hundreds of corn penetration tests. We developed a very quick technology for comb penetration. It's not static penetration, it's dynamic penetrations. And combined with SPT or its soil sampling, etc. So this is a soil cross-section from north to south. And at the top, we have a reclaimed sand here. And FAS means upper young alluvial sand. So these two soils cause liquefaction because age is still only, reclaimed land age is only 30, 40 years. And alluvial soil is 100 years old or more or less. So these two soils are guilty for liquefaction. So we have to improve soil conditions down to more or less 6 meters. Then underneath, there is AC layer. AC means alluvial soft clay. And thickness is 40 meters. You can easily imagine that 40 meter clay soil causes consolidation problem. So 1990s, people had a problem from AC. But this time, they have problem from AS and FS. So typical groundwater depths are also different, but just on as the average value, 1.5 meter below the surface, there is a groundwater table. So under 1.5 meters, liquefaction happened and affected the stability of house foundations. And we did many tests, soil sampling, liquefaction test, but I skipped this topic. Just please understand that we did lots of things to solve the problem in the past 5 years. So this is typical soil problem. SPT flow count is not big. And throughout alluvial sandy soil, SPT flow count is small. Then alluvial clay is a problem, like this. Underneath, at the bottom, you can notice the consolidation problem in the alluvial clay. Thickness is 40 meters. And this is an X-ray photo of undisturbed samples. I'm sorry, you cannot recognize the details of this photograph very much, but in this part, you can see seams. Seam appearance means liquefaction did not happen. But here, within these red squares, we cannot notice seams. This means sand was totally disturbed by water flow, upward flow, during liquefaction. So we did such efforts in addition to SPT, comb penetration, et cetera, et cetera. Well, this is Syria. You know that Damascus is under air raids, missile attack very much, but I visited Damascus before the battles. Damascus was very beautiful. It deserves our tourism. So I have trying to fix the problem geotechnically, I mean international society's relationship, but Syrian society people disappeared. They escaped to Russia, Finland, and yeah, I'm saying that war, battles are not don't help our disciplines. We can do good jobs under peacetime only. So, types of restorations. So, people's ideas different from country to country. Japanese people do not agree to move to safer places. That means they want to live in their existing houses. They don't allow us to demolish houses. But in New Zealand, Christchurch City has the same problem. Over there, they just sold all lands, houses, and moved to safer places. Houses were demolished, and then they can improve soil conditions. So here, open space, soil improvement is not difficult. But in Japanese cities, people want to maintain houses. So how can we touch soil under fragile, unstable houses? So we did many things, Here I'm trying to show you the mechanism of liquefaction. Sand grains can move back and forth during earthquakes, and water pressure develops, and effective stress disappears, and liquefaction happens like this. So we should stop grain movement by installing, I'll come back to this topic later. Okay, problem is this. There are very limited houses, very limited spaces among houses. So how can we work in such a narrow space? Minimum size is only 1.5 meters. So we cannot bring in big construction machines. And people insist that their houses should remain forever for another 20, 30 years. And we should not disturb the structure of houses. No tilting is allowed. So this requires very careful working under the houses. So this is a public project. So government decided to provide some financial support to improve soil. Okay, 50% is paid by national government, and 50% cost is paid by people's pocket money, and local city government decided to spend their income from Tokyo Disneyland to further support the people. Okay, so in principle, public money should not be spent on private properties. This rule is very strict. Financial ministry made strong resistance against the project. But finally, engineers got a very good excuse. Okay. Here on the your left, building subsided under downwards, and then soil was squeezed out towards the street. An uplift happened. Okay, this is a situation uplift. And under sidewalks, there are many important lifelines. So we have to stop liquefaction in private land in order to protect public properties, such as sewage, water, gas, telecommunication lifelines. That was the excuse to negotiate with the Ministry of Finance. And finally, we reached agreement. This procedure took 2 years. During 2 years period, people are just waiting for the conclusion. Oh, we are very sorry, but talking with non-engineer people are very difficult. Okay, this is another example of total distortion of ground after liquefaction. So method of soil improvement. You know that soil does not liquefy if soil is dry. So very good idea is water pumping and make soil dry. This is not expensive. However, the problem happened. Okay, this is an example in the oil refinery near Tokyo. This company was very, very smart to install this dewatering pumping technology to avoid future liquefaction. So area is surrounded by slurry walls. No water can come in the lateral direction. And underneath, there is an impervious clay layer. And water level was reduced. And they did detailed soil investigation, then calculated consolidations. And no damage so far happened. So tank is old. Tanks are old, but still they're working. So the company was able to continue the business. And on your right-hand side, there is another example. Here, liquefaction destroyed the entire town in 1995 during Kobe earthquake. After that, people decided to lower the groundwater level. I visited this area. I walked for 2 hours. I didn't find any evidence of consolidation settlement. This city was very fortunate because soil condition there is over-consolidated. So you are soil mechanic experts, so over-consolidated soil does not develop much settlement. So this technology is relatively cheap. This is good. But Uraya City has this problem. Soil is normally consolidated. And thickness is 40 meters. So groundwater pumping is very dangerous. But still, city government did small-scale testing on consolidation by pumping up water. People found this. They called the city government, asked, hey, what are you doing? The city government said, hey, we are pumping up water. The people got very angry. Why don't you take care of consolidation? You know, the, many, many problems, 1980s, 1990s, in democratic country. Government cannot continue such activity under people's angry environment. So immediately, city government gave up this pumping project. Immediately. So this cheap, nice technology was not possible in Urea City. So, but, so alternative idea is this grid wall under existing houses. So there is very small space among houses. So walls are constructed. Okay, ideas are like this. Okay, as I mentioned previously, cyclic shear deformation is a cause of liquefaction, back and forth. So we install very rigid soil cement mixing walls and form a grid under houses. And this grid wall prevents cyclic deformation and finally prevents liquefaction. But this is a bit expensive. This is a plan view. So red part is construction under streets, 100% paid by the government. And the blue dots show the cement mixing columns and among houses. So that part is paid 50% by government, 50% by people. And we form nice grid system. System is important. And this technology was verified in 1995. This hotel was located, situated upon this grid wall, and no damage happened. So we are trying to construct this grid wall again in Urea City. And this, that problem is this narrow space. Okay, this is design earthquake. We are trying to avoid repetition of same damage as happened in 2011. Okay, we did many centrifuge model tests. But centrifuge model test is very difficult because 1 millimeter subsidence in model scale means 5 centimeter subsidence in reality. And 5 centimeter settlement is already fatal, or people don't accept 5 centimeter subsidence in their houses. So we have to make many engineering judgment together with numerical analysis, and we concluded that this technology will work. Let's avoid this one. We did many studies about water pressure development, et cetera, by three-dimensional numerical analysis. Okay, we did many efforts. Then construction machine. Okay, this is a regular machine for soil cement mixing, but obviously this is too big. Such a machine will easily destroy people's houses. Not acceptable. So, we developed smaller machines. This is a platform. Okay. Underneath, there are fences among houses. Some people put vegetations, flowers on the ground floor, ground. So engineers can work upon elevated platforms, no disturbance to people's life. And this is a machine. So this machine goes down and mixes soil and cement. And this is testing of the machine. Pressure changes with the directions. So we try to make oval cross-section of soil cement mixing walls. No reinforcement is there for cost saving. So one oval is connected to another one. One oval is here, next one is there. And we continue this construction and construct a continuous wall. And this also testing text. We try to verify our technology. And we check the connectivity of one column and the other column. We need to make continuous structure underneath. So we verify this. Okay. And this is the smallest machine, manual operation. Okay, let me, because time limitation, okay. Please understand that after test constructions, we did coring to run laboratory test on shear strength of cement soil mixing. Okay, then, okay. This interaction between geotechnical engineering, civil engineering, and people. Project is conducted on group of houses, not single house. We aim to have 100 family to make unanimous agreement. Then we can make a big system of underground grid walls. Single house is never enough for stability. We need many families to unanimously join this project, and for joining the project, they have to pay some money, and money is not small. So we did lots of many meetings to explain everything. City government was one sector, technical advisory board was here, and the consultant joined, and contractor also joined. I was the chairman, and then this meeting took place in front of tens of thousands of residences. And cost, okay, we did lots of efforts to save money, but finally we reached a conclusion that 6 million yen means around approximately US $50,000 per family, per house is necessary. Oh, it's a huge money. But the central government provides 50% support. Then city government also promised to provide some support. So finally, personal expenditure became 2 million yen, one third of this. So $50,000 divided by three, approximately $17,000 was the expenditure for family. It's not small yet. So, okay, this is the expenditure by people. So people's points are already different from engineers' viewpoint. Okay, they wished to have good safety during future earthquake. Everybody can understand this. And I have to honestly say that the planned soil improvement does not prevent liquefaction damage during very rare earthquake. Very rare means once every 1,000 years, typically. We try to prevent damage if same earthquake happens again, same earthquake as 2011. I didn't say very rare one. And also, very strong earthquake is probabilistically unlikely in the coming 20 years. That's an excuse for technical advisory committee. So we say, don't worry too much about very rare event. So, and after 20 years, most houses will be reconstructed, demolished and reconstructed. So 20 years was a probabilistic target of safety. And soil improvement will increase the value of their land. For some people, this is good news because their property increases. But for some people, this is bad news because real estate tax will increase, heritage tax will increase. So we are a bit, technical committee was in between good and bad opinions. And some people don't want to spend $20,000. They say that too much because some people already spent big money on soil improvement immediately after the earthquake, so they don't want to pay big money again. Also, some people don't want to spend any money. They have cash money. They want to give cash money to their children. So no, we cannot say no. That's their freedom. So we have to be making lots of efforts to talk with people, let them understand the importance of the project. And the problem was people don't know anything about solid mechanics. So we made some thesaurus. Technical words are translated into very simple words, and we try to let people understand our idea to help people. And okay, this, let me skip this. We maybe got time limitation. Yeah, problem was cost for treatment of mud waste produced by soil improvement. This is a mixture of cement waste and mud, etc. And the environmental government, the environmental ministry didn't allow us to do cheap treatment. So we have to transport every waste to a factory at far distance, and it increased the cost. So this is the irony. What happens if one family refuses to join this project? Okay, this is the area. We expect 100 families to join. Okay, this family say, yes, yes, thank you very much. That's nice. Good news. Good. Yes, 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 yes. But this one does not say yes. We cannot blame this family. Some people are very poor. Then project, okay. It's interesting that this lot is still surrounded by walls. They don't pay any money, but surrounded and protected by walls. Money was paid by somebody else. Okay. Is this fair or not? This family does not pay money, but protected, just enjoy safety from other people's money. Such a discussion now going on. So this is one of the difficulties in engineering and people collaboration. So conclusion, my time is limited. So Urea City was hit by significant liquefaction damage. National government plus people carry out joint projects for soil improvement. I'm very sorry that 5 years and a half have passed after the earthquake. But problem was so difficult to solve. And technical development was made, cost reduction efforts are made, and many meetings have been held to transfer residents as many information as possible. And discussion for unanimous approval by residents is still underway. It was due in December 2011, but it due date was postponed. Still, negotiation, discussion are going on now. So please understand that in spite of many difficulties, geotechnical engineering should get understanding from people. Otherwise, our future will be difficult. So I'll be trying to get such recognition from people. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much for your presentation. And please wait, we have some token appreciation for you. ค่ะลำดับต่อไปนะคะดิฉันขอเรียนเชิญรองศาสตราจารย์ดร.สุทธิศักดิ์สรลำนะคะประธานคณะอนุกรรมการสาขาวิศวกรรมปัตตภีขึ้นเป็นผู้มอบของที่ระลึกให้กับโปรเฟสเซอร์โตตะค่ะเดี๋ยวอีกสักครู่จะเป็นช่วงของการพักเบรกนะคะเราจะกลับมาในห้องประชุมนี้อีกทีหนึ่งเวลา 11:20 นะคะเรียนเชิญทุกท่านเบรกท่านด้านนอกเลยค่ะขอบคุณค่ะ